Looks like you.
Looks like you too. He's got your eyes.
And he's got your nose too.
That's my boy.
You came close to losing him.
I know. Stubborn. You are so stubborn.
You just gave up too easily.
Now, you were pretty convincing.
You would have talked me into marrying you then if you just would have stuck around instead of running off to join a formal agent.
Maybe.
That's what I said. Especially after I found out I was pregnant.
Look, we've been through that, Jenny. You should have told me.
I know. But if I had, I never would have known if you really wanted to marry me, or if you just thought that you had to. It was awful. I had friends pressuring me all the time just to get an abortion. Get an abortion. Not even able to tell my own parents.
Yeah, maybe we ought to be grateful to them.
To who?
Your parents. If you hadn't had to keep them from finding out, you might have gone to a regular legal adoption agency. We never would have been able to find him. I never would have seen him at all. He's ours. And I love him, Jen.
I don't care what Mr. Lyles is doing. And you tell him that we'll be there in half an hour and we expect to see him. We'd better go.
Brian, are we making a mistake?
We're doing the only thing that we can do. If we go to the police, we'll lose Johnny.
We ought to check his grandma to see if the kid's really there.
Oh, forget it, Danko. You're worrying about something when there's no need to.
Lieutenant, just doesn't add up.
But I look here, did Mrs. McNeil seem nervous or upset when you were talking to her?
No, sir, but
did
I think
she... keep you from going in the house or examining the car?
No.
Did she seem as if she had something to hide?
No, sir.
Well, wouldn't it be more logical to assume that your witness at the supermarket biced up the license plates?
He seemed very sure, Lieutenant.
The world is full of reliable people, Webster, and they make mistakes.
I've been known to make a couple myself.
Yes, sir, you have.
I don't think this is one of them. Now, can we get on with the business of the day, gentlemen? Would you like to hit the bricks?
Lieutenant, if Mrs. McNeil isn't the right woman, then why doesn't the right woman come forth and report the child stealing?
Well, that's a good point, Danko. I think what we have here is a family dispute, a couple of parents who are fighting over visitation rights, but that's all.
Maybe you're right.
I took a cab from the market, and I found my car about 6 or 7 blocks away. It was at a bus stop, and he had left the keys in it. Johnny was gone.
Well, I'm not sure what you expect me to do, Mrs. McNeil. The child is not a refrigerator. There isn't any guarantee on parts or labor.
That's right. He's a human being. And for the $10,000 that I paid your so-called adoption agency, I expect you to guarantee that the adoption will stick.
You want your money back?
It's not a matter of money.
Richard, relax, Charlie. Professor wouldn't do anything foolish, now would you, Professor?
Mr. Lyles, we wanted a baby, desperately, but I couldn't have one. We made the rounds, we learned to play the agency game, and tell the social workers, exactly what they wanted to hear. It was humiliating. But they all turned us down. Because I am a diabetic. And the people who reviewed my case said that they felt my emotional stability was questioned. So finally, we came to you. And he was only 4 days old when we got him. I fed him. And I changed him. And I stayed up all night with him when he was sick. And I loved him. And now, you want to give us our money?
I'm sorry, Mrs. McNeil, but I'm afraid there isn't anything I can do for you.
Lyles, I want you to get our boy back for us, and if you don't, you're in trouble.
You're threatening me.
Yes, I guess I am. I'm not good at this, but I guess you had somebody planted in one of those legitimate adoption agencies we went to. They could tell you whose adoption request got turned down. They knew everything about us. How much I made, how much we had in the bank.
Go on, Professor.
Well, obviously you had to have people in Detroit, too, because you recruited the girl there. You probably have them all over the country. What do? Set up phony counseling and abortion centers to talk unwed mothers into letting you arrange the adoption. The girl said she only got her medical expenses, so you must have kept nearly all the $10,000. It's a good business, illegal but profitable.
Professor McNeil, I realize you're upset, and I sympathize with your problem. But you are way out of your league. I mean, a college professor shouldn't get involved in something like this. It would just take a word to one of my friends on the University Board of Regents. Let us say some hint of misconduct with one of your girl students, and you wouldn't teach again.
I'm a teacher, Lyles, and I love my work, but I would gladly wash dishes or sweep floors for the rest of my life to get my son back. And if you don't get him back, we'll go to the police.
All right. I will see what I can do.
We expect to hear soon.
Want me to take care of them in the usual way?
Oh, no, I don't think so. Now, they're respected members of the community. They're too visible to eliminate. You and Dad get right on it. Try that supermarket first. If he was driving a car, it might still be there. I'll get you a photograph of Stalker for identification.
This is it. Gotta be Stalker's.
Navy sticker on the windshield. What do you want to do? Stake it out?
Yeah. But let's check something else out first. Hey, kid!
We're police detectives.
Oh, hi. I'd
like to ask you a few questions, huh?
Sure.
Been hanging around here all day?
Yeah, but I'm not exactly hanging around.
Of course not. Tell me, how long's that van been there?
I don't know, a couple of days, maybe.
So you were around her then when the kidnapping occurred the other day?
Oh, yeah, sure, but I told the uniform officers everything I know.
Tell me, what this guy look like, this guy who did it?
21, 22, about 6 feet, and he had brown hair, and it was cut kind of close, and brown eyes.
Doctor Ulrich.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, we're closing up, so I gotta get back to work, okay?
Listen, you get back to work when I tell you to, not before. I mean, listen, son. Have you seen anybody else hanging around that van?
No, I haven't seen anybody. Hey, what is this, man? Hey, look, if you guys are from the police, I want to see your badges.
Don't be a hero, punk. Now you listen, and listen good. Anybody ask about us? We ain't been here, you got it?
Look, I gotta go.
Friend Sid, you haven't seen us or heard of us. Well, there's more where that came from. You dig?
Right.
I don't see how he can be. There's too many coincidences. Mrs. McNeil's got to be the one.
You mean you think that whole thing at the house was just an act?
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't be.
Okay.
No woman who's just lost her child.
There's still something missing. Something's wrong somewhere.
Mike, suppose you're right in a way. Suppose Mrs. McNeil had to lie to protect her child. Now, a woman could do anything to protect her, maybe.
Yeah. She assured us that there was no one in the house. She even offered to let us search. She gave us every reason to believe she had nothing to hide.
There probably wasn't anything in the house. But you know what? I think you should have followed your instinct. I think you ought to check with the grandmother tomorrow and make sure that...